Transnet releasing its first half earnings. Revenue up 11% year on year. That's to 24.9 billion rand. The logistics company increased the amount of coal it moves to 41.6 million tons. That's up 7.8% year on year. Also moving more iron ore and manganese. That's to 31.7 million tons, up 11.2% year on year. This is what Brian Malefe, CEO of Transnet, had to say on their relationship, that very precarious relationship with the miners.
We feel that the relationship has improved. In fact, as Mr. Gama says, we have even experienced an unprecedented cancellation of trains from the industry. So I would be surprised if they continue to say that Transnet is still a problem in terms of delivering trains that are required. We have increased our operations from 700 trains per day to 1,200 trains per day. So we're really trying very hard to meet the demand that is out there.
Viv, I think these are a good set of numbers. If you just look at the first half of the year, just running through all the numbers, revenue up 11%. I mean, what did worry me when I saw the numbers was operating expenses growing by 13.9%, pretty much 14%. They talk about staff costs as a result of the capital expenditure program, but they talk about energy costs. You know, what are your views on the job that management is doing at Transnet, as you know, in light of this capital expenditure program?
We were just talking just before the segment on it, and as Ashraf was talking about the fact that Transnet is more important than the numbers it gives out. It's not. It's like Eskom and like SAA, which has competitors out there. If we don't have a rail system run by Transnet, we have no rail system. If you have no electricity for Eskom, we have no electricity. Unlike SAA, which could go out of business and we'd have other people carrying our passengers' air freight, there'll be no one else doing the job that Transnet does right now. So its importance to the economy is not just the kind of numbers it gives out, but also the impact it has and the knock-on effect it has on the rest of the economy. And that's obviously something to be considered. They're embarking on massive infrastructure builds at the moment, including not just, you talk about rail, but also, you know, the ports, etc. These are going to be very important in order for the country to grow more in the future. The expenditure that you mentioned is obviously, you know, very important to have the capex come through, because if the country grows at the rate that we need to grow at to decrease unemployment, we would need Transnet to actually take on a much greater burden. And in fact, in this country, we have a bit of a dysfunctional transport system, in that we rely too much on road transport and not enough on rail transport, considering the advantages in terms of both efficiency, pollution, and other costs that come along with the cheaper rail transport.
And I suppose encouraging to see volumes in the freight business, which is their core business, up 7.5%, volumes in iron ore, manganese and coal all up.
Well, Samantha, it's encouraging, but when you see how far behind they are on their capital expenditure in terms of where they need to be right now in order to enable the economy to really grow at a rapid rate. You know, 6-7 months ago, when Brian was discussing his results, it was pointed out that if Transnet had actually spent money on that capex, then South Africa's growth rate would have been in the region of 5-6%.
But I mean,
that's the point. And we cannot get into a situation where management focuses on growing profits every year, which is exactly what Eskom did and paid themselves handsome bonuses, when they're not enabling the economy.
But so it does look like that, you know, from the numbers here.
And
they are spending
like
on capex.
They are, but they're not spending nearly enough yet. I think more needs to be spent, and the comment made that they're not making much in terms of profitability from the coal business. Yeah, sure, demand for coal is down, and therefore they'll be carrying less tonnage. But the reality is that when demand picks up, they have to be in a position to enable that. And I think that, you know, it's a case of management having to look forward, management not worrying about the bottom line, and it comes down to incentives. You know, government incentivizing by profitability for state-owned enterprises is the wrong way to go about it.
What type of incentives would you say should be there?
I'd say the first thing is to ensure that you are able to carry all the required freight, firstly. Secondly, profitability is important, so don't price yourself incorrectly, because that's what's happening. I mean, they price themselves, you know, incorrectly, and then not spend on capex, so they make a profit. But they have to take maintenance as well as expansion capex into consideration, because that's the only way they'll be able to run profitably. But profit shouldn't be the only focus for a company like Transnet. It should be, how do you enable the economy to grow? That's the first question they should be asking the exco. And if they cannot answer that properly and they cannot demonstrate it, well, then they shouldn't be paid any bonuses.
I hear what you're saying, but it is interesting to note that from an investment perspective, all the foreign investor community out there, even the local investors, they are supporting their CapEx plans. I mean, they said they raised 14.7 billion rand so far this year, and their target was 14.1. Mm-hmm. But that being said, they've been able to raise debt in the US market, and they say that they're not concerned about the fact that, you know, the likes of S&P have downgraded them in light of the sovereign. What are your views are on those kind of developments there?
Look, I mean, as a state-owned enterprise, you can't go off and say that we're going to be, you know, are we would support the downgrade, or we are too badly affected by it. That'll obviously, you know, cause trouble down the line. But obviously, a downgrade by S&P and by Moody's, etc., is going to have an impact on these very massive, as Asha mentioned, CapEx initiatives that we need to put through. We need to have, you know, spending on expansion by Transnet in order of tens of billions, possibly hundreds of billions of rands over the next few years. And we're talking about even a slight increase in interest rates that we have to pay because of these downgrades will have a massive knock-on effect on the company.